Hey, so Azure Advisor gives me personalized recommendations based on a well-architected framework so I can better use my cloud resources. Why don't we take a look? So let's go to Advisor, right over here. And I'm gonna click on All Recommendations. Let's see, this one says, enable virtual machine replication to protect your applications from regional outages. Gosh, I wonder what that means. I wish I could go to some sort of advisor clinic. You know, maybe I can. Well, you know, I have Travis Maier here, and I suspect you know what this means. Hey, Travis, I know what backup is, but I'm not quite sure what this is trying to tell me when it says enable virtual machine replication. What's going on here?
Hey, no problem, David. So in addition to backup, a lot of our customers are really focused on disaster recovery, right? And making sure that our workloads are redundant, right? And not just backed up. Meaning that if we had a planned or an unplanned type of outage, right? Maybe it's planned, meaning that it's happening because we're doing upgrades to different applications or we're testing our disaster recovery, but it may be unplanned as well, right? Some kind of natural disaster, things of that nature. In those cases, what we want to be able to do is introduce resiliency in the form of being able to access backups that are in another region and make those come online as quickly as possible to make sure that we reduce downtime to the extent possible.
So that makes total sense. Can you, so how do I do this?
Yeah, why don't we take a look at an example deployment here. So what you'll see here is that we're currently deployed in the West US region. In this case, we're just using a single VM. And what we wanna make sure, given our policy at an example corporation, that we'd be able to, in an event of a disaster, fail over to another region. In this case, what we've done is we've selected the East US region. And it's actually very simple. You can see here that I'm just in an example VM. I've selected the target region. We're already in West US. And what we're able to do after that is set the exact policy that we want when that failover takes place. The interesting thing here is that there's a lot of different configuration. We probably won't go into a ton of detail here, but you can see that you're able to select your target settings for the new region, in this case, East US. So what we're gonna do is select the subscription, the resource group, but you can also have flexibility around the virtual network that you're going to be failing over to, assuming that you'll have to replicate, you know, many different enterprise applications and Active Directory and DNS and things of that nature. You can set the virtual network to accommodate for that.
Okay, so that makes total sense. I think in my experience, like, people are really good at setting up disaster recovery, but they're not so great at knowing whether what they've set up works. Do we have a way to help with that? Like, how do you know once you've set this up that it's doing what you want it to?
Absolutely. Yeah, this is one of my favorite features. I know that a lot of people have no problem setting it up, but they want to have that confidence in hand that when the disaster hits or when an unplanned event happens, that they're going to be able to have full confidence that the failover is going to take place. So actually within our configuration, we offer the ability to test those failovers. And there's both kind of human testing as well as testing within the service itself. So what you can see here, again, pretty simplified view of this, we're failing over from West US to East US, and we're selecting the recovery point that we want to use. Maybe there were some specific changes that were made in an application or a VM, and we want to select a specific recovery point. We'll then select the virtual network, as we discussed earlier, and kick off the test failover. In this example on the right-hand side, I've already kicked off that failover, and you can see here that we have individual itemized processes that take place. And what you can see here also is that it took just over 2 minutes for us to fully fail over to that new region. So we can just highlight here that we do have existing VMs in that region that have been backed up from our West US location, and those have been activated, they're online, and they have shown successful here. Typically, our customers are also gonna take this a step further. They'll RDP into the actual VMs and make sure that everything is meeting their needs.
So that's really cool. And I think now I have a better understanding what this looks like. And I have to say, I really dig the fact that you can see how long it takes, because that's often something people don't have a good sense of. Thank you very much, Travis, for coming, and thank you all for watching this. I really appreciate you joining us here on this episode of Advisor Clinic in the Azure Enablement Show. Join us next time for another great episode.